Hello everyone. Okay, for the questions of here, have a look. Okay, so question number B. Okay, diagram. Okay, show the quadrilateral of ABC, EFGH and EJKL drawn on the Cartesian plane. Okay, so describe the full transformations from the image of EJKL to from ABCD, meaning from ABCD to become EJKL. So what are the combined transformation? So our objective today is to identify the combined transformations, okay, from ABCD to EJKL. So this is the okay, this is the object, this is the image. Okay, so first of all, they're given to you the combined transformations is VW. So again, so if transformations for VW, this is the first step. Okay, this one will be the second step. Okay, so meaning the first step is W, the second step is V. Okay, so now we'll do the first one. What is W? So just like previously what I'm telling you people, so you have to guess. There are four types of transformations. So translations, we have translations, rotation, we have reflection, and we have enlargement. Okay, so we need to guess which one is related to our questions. Okay, so I have enlarged the picture, so have a look here. Okay, so A, B, C, D to become E, J, K, L. Actually, E, J, K, L consists of two objects, which is E, F, G, H is one of the smaller quadrilateral, and EJKL is a bigger. So you can see this is starting point here is object. Okay, so the object to become the final image EJKL is a bigger size, smaller to bigger. So again, so enlargement is our choice. Okay, so there must be one of the transformation is enlargement, and as I told you before, enlargement always the second step. Okay, so according here, second step is V. So here V is already we are enlargement. Okay, so this is enlargement. So another one, so we have to choose. So from here to here we have enlargement because the object is bigger size sources. The other one is, you can see from ABCD to EFGH, this is an intermediate image. Okay, ABCD to EFGH, intermediate image. So from here to here you see the object is being rotated. Because with translations, the orientation of the object doesn't change, but this one already changed. You see, the orientation is changed. Okay, if reflection, the object must be symmetric, but this one, these two are not symmetric at all. So the second transformation we identify is rotation, but this one is the first step. Okay, so this one first step rotations. So now we can write down here W is normally in SPM is either 90 degree or 180 degree, but here is 90 degree because you can see from here to here is actually a 90 degree. So we must identify whether it's clockwise or anti-clockwise. So there are a few methods to identify. So one of the methods is using a transparent. Anything can be transparent. This is a plastic bag. So we copy the image. Okay, turn off the light first. Okay, because it's a reflection. So I copy it on a piece of a transparent plastic. This is one of the way. We copy the object. Okay, roughly lah. No need to 100%. Because I need to know where is the center of the rotation. Okay, now you see. I've copied already, you see, okay. So now I want to rotate this object to EFGH. Okay, so I try to place any points on the Cartesian plane, but you have to try to see the best point now. So I try. Let me try this one. Okay, so I press this one. Okay, I hold it and I turn the paper. I turn the plastic bag. Okay. Yeah, so this is what I mean. This is a rotation, you can see. Again, I repeat. So from here, I turn the plastic bag. Okay. So you can see, it is really matched, absolutely matched. So meaning, this is the center of the rotations, and the rotation is from here to here. Okay, so here to here is anti-clockwise. Okay, so because the clock, the needle of the clock is turned from going downwards, but this one going back. So center and anti-clockwise. So I repeat. Again, I look. I just copy the object, and I turn the plastic bag. So it's matched to the intermediate image. So it's matched. So meaning this is the center. Okay. So this is the center, meaning it's here. Okay. So this is negative 2, negative 4. Okay. This is negative 2, negative 4. So the center is negative 1, negative 4. Okay. So now the answer for this one is 90 degree anti clockwise rotation. Okay. About the center. Okay. Write down the coordinates. Okay. So this is 0, negative 2, negative 4. So this is 0, negative 1. So it's negative 1, negative 4. Okay. So this is for W. Okay.